Thank you, game.
Well, I'm going to go put hats on people, I guess. I really wish I could put hats on my hair troll.
It's just a thing we do sometimes. We just go and put hats on people. Oh, geez, Horatio's 14 already. There's progress.
All right, here we go.
How many giants are you using now? Oh, my God.
The smallest team.
It's just a team of giants. Yeah, you know what? I don't need a tank. You can tank. I just use a net on my tank. We're fine. Everything's fine.
Team of big people.
Team it works. Big people. Why not?
Oh my God, some of these shields are great.
Oh, so it's a bad idea to grab too many things because it uses up the same inventory space as treasure, huh? Oh, but you can store it. Okay, cool. So you can put stuff in storage in the lockers over here, I think, so you don't have to sell the stuff to make space.
Okay. I've never looked into that.
Neat. Oh, super chaperone. Help Gluten check on his best friend, Scrumptious.
I don't know if this guy's even going to be able to fight, but it's amazing. We should probably do the pooper one first. Take me to Tinkletown, because the cupcake one actually is, like, hard. You're supposed to start with Tinkletown, as far as I remember.
Oh.
Yeah.
So, escort Gooseberry's shy bladder to Tinkletown. Oh, that sure is a sentence that was said.
Yep.
Okie dokie.
Yep.
Auto Battler allows you to play like a manager. What does that mean?
I was actually messing around with Auto Battler earlier. The entire point of it is your characters just fight for you automatically.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's pretty much just AI versus AI. It's
yeah,
not
I figured
bad.
I figured that much. Just fight like a manager was a weird detail. I guess that just mean like you pick who the is in the fight and then just see what happens?
Yep.
That seems like it'd be really boring, unless the auto-battler also makes it go faster.
Like
fast-forward faster, not just automatically proceeding faster.
I think it does. I mean, it is definitely faster, because it very quickly makes the decision.
I just figure I'd want the fights to be over in like a couple of minutes if it's gonna be me not playing.
Yeah.
Hello, friend. Welcome to Tinkletown. It's a giant Greek toilet. Sure. Wow, Tinkletown. I used to think it was just a legend. Well, you know, peeing is believing. This is a really big toilet. This is going to be one of those adventures, isn't it? Guys, I think Gooseberry is having trouble in there. We should probably go in and help him out. Oh, no. Please be bandits, please be bandits, please be bandits.
Oh my God, that's a lot of dudes.
It's a toilet mushroom! Bandits in Tinkletown.
In Tinkletown? Unthinkable!
Oh, thank goodness.
Quick! I can't go while they're watching.
I can't go while they're watching. It's the dedicated right. town for peeing. You can't do it anywhere else in town.
All right, Keith, move your guys back.
Are you just gonna charge forward?
I'm just gonna make the defensive line. And move it slowly forward. I don't think we have to defend Gooseberry. Do we have to defend Gooseberry?
Do you check the objective?
Nope, we don't have to. Gooseberry can die. And we don't have to worry about it.
And probably will.
Yeah.
There we go. Yeah, there needs to be a better way of choosing characters.
Yes.
Because scrolling through seven people is an ordeal. Oh, they're shooting us with plungers, of course.
Yeah? Oh yeah. Get ready for some shit-themed, levels
here. Is that a shit-eating mushroom over there? Motor man.
Yeah. He has... I don't know.
I don't know. I give up.
I'm just trying to figure out where to move my guys around to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, weird. I'm not getting line of sight on with my archer at all.
Like
I can't attack anyone.
That's directly next to a unicorn horn. You might want to move two of your characters. Or not.
We'll see what happens.
Yeah, they don't always explode, which is the really confusing part. Nope, there they go. Okay.
Oh, my poor bladder! You know flushing flatulators!
Alright. Get in your face!
Let's see. Can I get around? Not easily. I guess I'll move there.
Oh, weird. That mushroom's an enemy. Okay.
Yeah, it got flung somehow. I'm not sure where
went on a trip.
Yep.
Trying to move my characters in. God damn it. There we go.
How many enemies are there? 3, 6, 8, 11.
Weird. Your character seemed to knock seemed to knock the mushroom away while I was still shooting him, and then the rest of the shots didn't land.
That sucks. The big guys have the ability to just smack people around. It's kind of inconsistent, though, which sucks. I almost wish you could, like, pull up a special attack in this game.
And have direct control over every action and stuff like that?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I understand why they did it the way they did, but it'd be really nice if I had, like, a super hit on a cooldown that I could specifically, like, actually do tactics as opposed to just throw my guys into the fray and hope for the best. That guy is a saxophone. Catch him.
Oh, that guy does have a saxophone.
That is a nice saxophone. Honestly, though...
He's going to die.
He is going to die.
He is in the fray.
Here, let's try and... I'm going to try and catch one of the goblins on the toilet, though. That should be a lot easier to do specifically. Okay. Results are in. Trying to build one of these big guys for defense, not worth it. Trying to build one of these guys for, like, sheer destruction, very worth it.
Mostly just gonna settle for stabbing the shit out of their archers.
Yeah.
There we go, everyone's attacking now. I've moved my characters to positions where stuff actually is happening now. Random gas mask mushroom is continuing to pierce our defenses, though.
Yeah, the gas mask mushroom is kind of a jerk. Oh, here, I'll see if I can go smack him around a bit. Maybe I can give him the old alpaca kiss.
Horatio, no!
Oh, it's almost dead. Wow, that does damage. Yeah.
I like that when you kill a mushroom, its corpse is like a pizza slice mushroom.
It's great. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to rethink my whole, defensive Cyclops guy. He kinda sucks.
There we go, that worked out.
Okay.
We are no longer being penetrated by mushrooms.
Yep.
Enjoy that sentence in any context.
I mean, there are worse things to be penetrated by.
Horatio, no!
Like, I definitely wouldn't want to be penetrated by that saxophone in comparison to that mushroom.
Are we rating things on the hierarchy of penetration now?
I mean, what else are we going to do? Unlike most tactical games that we've played in the past, it's like, I'm going to move my guys over here and hope for the best, I guess.
Stamper's so happy when death happens.
It's great.
I just wish he was talking ever.
I'm trying to remember when plot happens. Either we walk somewhere specific, or we pick it. I think we just pick it after a certain point, but I actually have totally forgotten. I know you unlock story fair.
We're all gonna be shooting the same mushroom over here, I think. I think both of my throwing characters and my archer are all going to shoot the same person. Oh yeah, that's bad for them. This is a nasty combo.
I might actually be able to catch Sax guy depending on how things go. Probably not. It's a small chance. Wow, yeah.
My kobolds are not going to last.
Oh wow, yeah, they are getting specked around a bit.
But I shall join them in Valhalla.
Yeah, I don't think Sax guy's gonna live through this. Oh, that's okay. At least I've got their melee front line pretty much down.
Wow, your mascot is getting hammered.
Yep, but he leveled up, so it doesn't matter.
Hey!
Yay, RNG.
Let's see.
It's bizarre watching the fucking unicorns. So they move by sliding their ass around like dogs trying to leave their ass plans.
They are not functional as actual unicorns. They're just...
They're more function adjacent.
Yeah.
Well, I'm doing a lot of stabbing, so that's probably a good start.
Nope, didn't get the double kill.
Horatio's gone, so I can't capture anything.
Okay. Oh, you gave Horatio your net?
Yeah.
It's generally... Who's... Oh, he is your hero.
Okay. Yeah.
I was gonna say, if he's not your hero, you should probably switch him to... Because...
Yeah, I gave him the next... He's the only melee character in the entire party. It's kind of not...
It seems to be working out
super well advised.
You're not doing terribly.
Yeah, it's just bad for a survival.
Yeah.
Which is kind of necessary for using nets. he was the shield user. But I want to capture one more humanoid if I can.
I could just give you one. I got a billion. I've caught too many random humans, and I have no use for them. No Sax Guy. Hey, who knows? We might pick up Sax Guy. Or Sax Guy's weapon, at the very least. And if
just
not,
off the ground.
Oh well.
Hey, level ups! That's almost as good as having a healer in the party.
It's better.
Just constant level ups.
Yeah. That's part of the reason why I'm like, cupcakes.
Cupcakes. Who needs them? It's all about cup pies.
Okay, so leave
the
goblin.
My entire party's gonna attack the same unicorn. Jesus.
That poor unicorn. There it goes. Okay, pull everybody back.
That
I'm
was
gonna
a
go...
severe punishment.
I'm gonna go capture that that goblin. With my incredibly slow beefcake. Oh, it works.
As long as
don't
he's not in range of my
me.
Archer, at least.
I think he got hit by, like, one arrow, but that's not gonna matter. Yeah, I've actually never managed to catch one of these guys, because they're kind of flimsy.
There we go, now the archer will be out of range. Yeah, it's a gnome. He likes wrenches, I guess.
Gnomes, well, they're extremely lazy, yet helpful. One moment they're launching each other a great distance, the next, fixing robots. So they can repair robotic, units, apparently, and I guess they have the ability to catapult people in directions. I'm never gonna use that. Unless I go for the all-robot team, maybe. Uh-oh.
If they fix robots, does that mean they do it without killing themselves like cupcakes? Because that'd be good.
Yeah. Oh, what a relief! We can go now! Okay.
Specifically, we. Wow, MVP was the kobolds now. They were just stabbing. Just constantly stabbing.
I like it how on my end, my hair troll always gets MVP, because the healing he heals from himself counts, and so it always, like, overinflates his score.
Yeah, because clearly the boss did the most damage, with 172.
Yep. Yeah,
But he's just healing himself, so he's self-applying his own score. Shortcutting his way to victory.
Well, back we go.
Yep, back we go.
I guess we could pop some campfires if you wanted to heal up and fight something.
Does that revive people, though?
No, it doesn't. But, like, you're just... Oh, wait, you can't capture anybody.
Nope. Money!
Alright, that's fine. And according to, person in chat, gnome healing does not... consume their own HP. So yeah, if you wanted to do a
real healer of some kind,
a
sweet.
Gnome robot. Oh right, I should probably give you the robot that I was offering.
Oh yeah. Oh, by the way, I finished Tyranny.
It just
ends.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Have you reached the end of it yet, or do you know about that?
No.
Oh, bad
I just
bow.
Know about it because people told me.
Yeah, you're almost done getting all the. Objectives that you can do in any order, and then suddenly it's like, starting the ending now, and then you do, like, two things, and then it's like, credits! I'm like, what?
Yep.
Like, were you planning a sequel, or did you just run out of game?
Ran out of game.
I got a letter. You received an item. Stranger. Is he in? There he is.
Okay, let's see what else, now I've got what little, else can I give you.
I've got this bow man. I've got scimitar net man. I've got three archers, one throwing weapon character, and my stabby gnomes. Or kobolds.
Seems reasonable.
This should work out.
Okay. Well, I picked a side quest, but honestly, let's just go people catching. You might want to grab some campfires.
You're talking about the unrest room?
Yeah, I picked up the unrest room, but honestly, you should probably, if we're just going to be doing random encounters for a moment, you should probably pick up at least one more fire.
Okay.
I guess I'm loaded on fires too, so that's helpful.
So have you been playing this the enemy's with, formation like corn on a cob?
Have you been playing this with keyboard and mouse or controller?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see.
At first, I figured this was a genre that just perfectly fits keyboard and mouse, but
here,
then
let's get you a fairy.
Then we encountered how the controls work. But I don't really want to deal with hooking it, switching the hookup between my Xbox and my PC right now.
Wow.
So I've just been making do. That's a lot of enemies. Hi.
That is, it's an okay amount.
There's two hair trolls in there.
My guys are not in a good position.
You're about as far away as possible from the setup.
Yeah. You want to run south? Because, like, I'm slow.
Could probably do that. Ah, crap.
Let's see. So I'd probably say catch a hair troll. But I don't know. It's up to you. Or I could catch a hair troll.
Many characters to move individually. Okay, here we go.
This is the one fear of you doing nothing but doubles. It would get... it'd be a problem after a very short while.
It's weird because it could be rectified by just the most basic control scheme change. But as far as I can tell, the only way to change characters is just awkwardly mouse wheel through them. And their order doesn't make sense. Like, the kobolds aren't even in next to each other in the scrolling order. Isn't that weird?
Yeah, it just chooses based on whatever it wants.
I think it's
which
it might
is
be
really
top,
weird.
Oh, it's top to bottom.
Oh, you're right.
It's top to bottom on the verticality of the screen, which is weird.
Huh.
It's top to bottom, then left to right. That's really... That's odd.
It works, I guess.
That's a strange system.
I'm gonna turn down the music on this game just a little bit.
Well, that's definitely consistently inconsistent, I suppose.
So
it looks like you're heading up here.
While I wait for your turn, I've been looking at
I'm creating
the Steam
formations.
Discussions. Dan Paladin is like their public relations guy, which is kind of surprising to me. Like, it's just kind of weird when you see like the lead dev for a somewhat large company one way or another doing a lot of the work.
That is focus fire. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was very
Everyone's
direct.
Just firing on the same enemy. But he's got a shield.
Yep. Ow.
Whoa.
Ow, he is going to die.
Those were a lot of hits.
Fairies hurt.
Wait, why am I doing that? Whoops. I almost ended the turn without sending my kobolds in.
Oh, that would be bad. Okay. Shoot. The one problem is... we need to get to those archers and kill them. I still don't understand what the percentage means in this game.
Probably crit. You do crit in this game. My kobolds do it all the time.
It's just weird, though, because I'm looking over at one of these archers, and he's got, like, a 27%, followed by, like, a 15, which oh, you know what? That's the percentage of how much damage they've done for the team. No, that's not it. I don't know, I give up.
I have now given up on life. I don't know what anything means, and I'm going to stop trying.
Yeah. Okay. Catching guys here is going to be rough, because we need to kill those archers before we do anything else.
Well, my archers remain relatively safe. Everyone's just hammering things. Holy crap.
And your archers shoot me from behind. I see how it is.
Do they actually hit you?
Yeah. Yeah, there's friendly fire in this game. Not just like AoE friendly fire, but like...
Just random?
Yeah, if a ranged character misses, they can and will hit. Wow, your Horatio is...
unshielded.
Yeah!
That's the specific outcome that happens when someone doesn't use a shield.
I'm a little surprised.
Yeah, my characters aren't particularly leveled. So everyone kind of just goes down.
Really like to know what level everybody else is, like, from the NPC perspective.
Yeah. It's one of those situations where you don't get a lot of perspective for how powerful your characters are versus anything, because you don't know anything about your opponents.
I was actually saying this earlier in regards to, on your Discord, how if anybody else made this game, it probably would be terrible. But because Behemoth made it, it's actually, like, really good. Which is really strange.
There's gonna be a lot of archer focus fire in one spot. Yep, there it goes.
Okay, so...
she got straight to hell.
I want to try and keep one of these hair trolls alive. I like that dumb flower head. Maybe.
Nice, maybe you can dodge me to death. Now they're becoming sassy hair trolls. That's the ultimate outcome of the situation.
Okay, let's kill one of them and then just suffer the other one. Actually, yeah. I'll try and get the archers and the fairy down.
I'm just gonna stab the crap out of the one that's in the middle of all my archers.
Yeah, that seems reasonable.
Jeez, that's so many attacks on one enemy. And still not enough.
There's still numbers going in. Well, hair trolls, since hair trolls count as, two people, they have stats to,
stats. So we're fighting a huge team by their standards, then.
Yes. Okay, I'm just gonna chuck nets. I'm gonna try and kill...
definitely losing Horatio.
Random guy. Ow. Yeah, your Horatio is, Well.
Yeah, this both poorly.
Yep, there we go.
There he goes. He exploded. Bye, main character.
Well, I can give you the spare hair
Horatio
troll.
Dies. Stamper was right. What's funny to me is I called the first episode of this game Horatio Dies, and someone called it clickbait. And I'm like, it's literally the line that's repeated over and over again by Stamper in the episode. That's the joke. It's because he doesn't die.
Yeah, he doesn't. He still doesn't.
Arrows for everybody. There we go.
Oops. Oh, don't kill that hair troll.
That's one less hair troll.
Okay, so let's try and ignore the hair trolls past this point, because, man, do I not want these archers.
Let's see. It'd be kind of hard...
Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put my big guy always one square away and chuck nets at him. Yeah. You just have everybody sprint away.
Yeah, it might be difficult to avoid killing this hair troll.
Yeah, we'll find out. Yeah, I mean, if it doesn't work, it doesn't work, and I can always catch it on my own. The other reason why we're out here is experience.
Yeah, I mean, there's another hair troll to go after, too. It just doesn't have the flower hat.
That's mine.
Oh, that is yours. Whoops.
Yeah.
If only there was team colors. Well, the thing under them, kind of, but still.
Yeah. Okay, if we're lucky, I can check. Okay, he's been netted. And I just sent you a present.
You sent me a present?
Yeah, there's an archer standing directly next to you.
Oh, I thought you were taking you literally, and I'm like, I'm confused. Where is it? Like, I don't know how to find this present. Where is it? Let's see, they're all now in range to automatically attack this guy. Good. Good. Can't do much about the bottom one, though. Their hair troll threw this guy.
I mean, it's okay. The hair troll can heal itself, so... yeah. As long as we're not specifically focus firing it, it'll probably die last. Whereas that archer...
is dead now.
Having a bad day. Yep.
Oh.
Okay.
The hair troll is not continuing to be netted, no!
It's okay, the other one's going down, the other person's going down pretty quick. I think there's a, diminishing return on how many times you can net the dude. But I'm not sure what it is. Yeah, so I'll take this hair troll's flower hat, and then I'll give it to you.
He's covered in blood! Multiple. Is that an actual, is that an actual bleeding effect, or is he just low on health?
That just means he's low on health. Which works. I like how creepy boss looks. He's just like, I'ma catch you.
You're talking about which one is boss? I can't tell.
The guy looking down.
That does narrow it down a lot. Hey, you just have two nightmare broken neck people that look up and down. What the fuck?
There's a side quest actually where I got these faces from. We should go find it at some point. It's pretty great.
I think until I saw the looking up guy, I think I was interpreting the other character as just being a giant nose face. But now I can't unsee that he's just a horribly, like, weird neck broken down tilted thing. Horatio's MVP, he died immediately.
What did he do? Utility.
Yeah,
I guess.
He threw nets every turn. Which makes him automatically the best on my team. Because he threw lots of nets.
If we go back into town, he'll just automatically recover.